caves I've ever gone in. This one just made my body vibrate. The closer I got to it, the crazier my body felt. And I was like, all right, I'm not going to go in there right now, but I'm coming back someday.
The desolate and dry desert north of Las Vegas. The setting of a baffling mystery that has captivated the imagination of people across the internet.
It came down this valley.
With several million following the story online.
This is a canyon I just walked up in.
It all began in 2014 when a YouTube user calling himself Snakebit McGee posted a video about having an otherworldly experience as he approached a mysterious hidden cave shaped like a capital M somewhere in the Sheep Mountains, close to the U.S. government's Nevada Test and Training Range, the largest adjoining military air and ground space in the free world. This government land is home to both Nellis Air Force Base and Area 51, the infamous highly secretive government testing site, which urban legend says houses the wreckage of alien spacecraft and possibly aliens themselves. Snakebit McGee's strange experience and the mystery that followed is leading people to draw their own conclusions. Did he stumble onto government secrets near Area 51?
I can't comment on Area 51.
Did he fall victim to desert outlaws?
There are certainly places out there where a body could be hidden.
Or to the desert itself.
It's brutal. This desert has been claiming lives for thousands of years.
There's mountain lions out here.
We are seeking to find the answer to what happened to YouTube user Snakebit McGee, a.k.a. Kenny Veach.
Hi, my name is Kenny.
Kenny, he was fun. He was just fun.
Always smiling. He was a really happy guy.
Fuzzy little lamb.
He loved having fun. He was really funny. He always had me laughing.
Watch this.
Woo! He just had this ability to connect with people.
Hold on. Now watch this.
He could talk to them and he just inspired. And it was all this energy. This life that was inside of him.
This is my tarantula in here. I'll get dun, 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 dun. She's a beauty.
Clever. He was very clever.
It's very heavy because it used to be a steel bar, just a steel bar, and I bent it into a circle and cut it.
Definitely multifaceted. He liked a lot of different things.
I created this little thing myself in the sand I found in two different deserts.
Kenny is a man of many passions, but most of them revolve around one thing.
The desert.
He saw how beautiful the desert was, and the wonder and the life that's there.
It's definitely a desert tortoise. I think he's acting like a rock, so I don't mess with him.
A lot of people that haven't been raised in the desert, they just see, you know, a barren wasteland, but it is anything but that. There's so much life out there, so many different types of plants and creatures.
There'd be like a board, you know, in the middle of the desert, he'd flip it up and be like, oh, see, there's a rattlesnake underneath there.
Kenny would head out alone far beyond cell coverage, exploring the wonders of the desert.
I find dried things that most people consider weeds, and I'll put that in a jar. These are seed pods that I find on my hikes, and I put them around.
He would seek out old deserted towns and mines and hunt for treasures that most of us call junk. He would use them as decor.
There's so much stuff from old ghost towns that are just disappearing out here in Las Vegas. This car had been washed down this old wash of a mountain that I was climbing, and I found that in the trunk.
The desert had always been a big part of his life.
This is something I've got on one of my hikes.
He grew up here, just outside the city of Las Vegas.
That was our life as children. Just leaving the house, and we'd just head out into the desert and hike and look and find critters and just explore. It's what we did.
I just came across these, and they have just opened and dropped gigantic sweet pine nuts or pinion nuts, whatever you want to call them. They're perfect. I'm a happy camper.
Kenny spent so much time in the Mojave Desert that he seemed to be untethered from the grim realities of this unforgiving landscape.
There was like one thing to describe him, like nature man.
The one thing I do know about Kenny is he was an amazing hiker as far as distance. He used to pride himself on how far can I hike, how far can I go without drinking a lot of water.
It's kind of dangerous, and I try to pretend like I don't have any supplies. You know, I bring water and I bring something to eat, but I haven't eaten anything since I started this hike, and I've only had two small gulps of water.
He was a very good hiker, and he amazed me.
It starts turning into cliffs and stuff that I got to start climbing down. It gets a little hairy.
We love to hike, not on trails, off trail. We did, I call it wild hiking, kind of like wild camping. It's not a campground. It wasn't a hiking trail. We just trailblazed through the desert. And sometimes we would spend 9 hours together in the desert. But usually his hikes by himself were overnight trips.
So I slept up in these mountains, and it's pretty high.
And they were never really usually one night. It was always two, possibly four nights, because he could carry enough water with him.
I'll put a pack on and hike up to 15 to 20 miles just to get to the mountain. And then I'll climb all the way to the top of the mountain. No matter how I gotta get there, I climb and climb and climb. And when I get to the top, I spend the night, no matter how many times I feel like spending the night, however long my water supply lasts, and I come back down the mountain a different way.
And it was during one of these far off the beaten path nature hikes where Kenny said he stumbled upon the mysterious cave that he claimed was emitting some kind of seemingly supernatural force. And that's where the mystery begins.
Every time I go out into the desert exploring, I think, what could have happened to Kenny?
Eric Cacinero is a journalist and author of the book Odyssey of a Ghost Town Explorer. He has studied the Veach case extensively and wrote an article about Kenny for Nevada Magazine in 2019. He is fascinated with the story that evolved after Veach posted about his unlikely encounter with the mysterious desert cave.
When Kenny posted his comment, people naturally kind of called him out on it. And, you know, said, where's the proof? So Kenny's mission after that was to go out and show proof of this cave.
I told him, hey, I'm coming out here, you know, because they kind of called my hand on it.
And so he went out to the place where he had gone before, which is located about an hour north of Las Vegas in the Sheep Range.
Kenny, a.k.a. Snakebit McGee, armed with the pistol and his video camera, set out to document his search for the M-shaped cave that had terrified him on his first encounter. And his persistence in finding the cave would lead only to more questions.
No, something's just not right here.
And wild theories.
They have all kinds of electronic equipment out there that detects you, that you can't see, of course.
Kenny Veach was on a hike through the desolate Mojave Desert when he encountered a cave on the side of a mountain that he said sent terrifying vibrations through his body. After posting about the odd experience, Kenny was encouraged by web users to return to the cave and seek answers.
My mission today is to just do a one-day hike. It's about a 10-hour hike. I got to still go over another ridge and then go all the way down a big crevice that's real narrow and gets kind of scary. And I'm looking for a cave that I found, and I didn't have a sidearm when I was here before.
What Kenny produced on his journey was the now infamous M Cave hike video.
Hopefully I'll find that cave. It's like back over there somewhere.
His M Cave hike is a wandering, lighthearted journey.
Whew, I'm gonna be worn out, but that beer's gonna taste good.
Kenny takes us across mountains and through canyons.
Yeah, a little bit of drop off. I think I should be able to scale down these bushes.
He spotted animals, including a desert tortoise.
He's neat looking.
And bighorn sheep.
Look at him. That's why I love coming out here. You never know what you're gonna see.
He ate pine nuts.
They're everywhere.
And by all accounts, Kenny seemed to be enjoying himself.
There's some interesting stuff coming up here. Look at that.
But the one thing he did not accomplish...
There's lots of little caves, but they're not the kind of cave I'm looking for.
...was find anything resembling an M cave.
Well, I did not find the cave. That is so weird.
When Kenny returned home and posted the video, it was not long before the comments began streaming in.
People, yet again, start calling him out, you know, pretty much saying, okay, well, you went out to find this cave, you know, and you said it exists, and then you posted this video and there is no cave still. So YouTube users kind of egged him on a little bit,
But one comment stands out as being ominous in the comment section, and it said, no, don't go back out to that cave. If you end up finding M Cave, you won't get out. And so that comment has since been deleted off of YouTube.
It wasn't just Kenny's claims of the cave's strange vibrations that triggered all the comments. It was its location.
Being that its proximity was so close to Nellis Air Force Base and Area 51, a cave of this nature just seems kind of mysterious.
So with the growing social media interest in the M Cave, Kenny promises online to give it one more try.
I think Kenny liked the attention. I think he saw this type of content that he was posting stirred emotions in people. I think that he realized that people wanted to see more, and I think he felt obligated to produce more.
So on November 10th, 2014, after parking his vehicle in the Mojave, Kenny started walking.
So much goes on in the desert. There's so many things we don't know.
A cave of this nature just seems kind of mysterious.
Mojave Mystery, Vanished in the Desert, a 2-hour special event, real life nightmare, Sunday at 9 on HLN.